Inaugural session han ika-12 nga sangguni ang panglungsod nga gindumara ha din ika-3 San Hulyo, Miyerkules nga adlaw, inhumalaban istorya bahin han pagpili han floor leader han konseho. Gamit han usa nga opinyon han Department of Interior and Local Government, inging question han bago nga napili nga konsehal Evangeline Esperas, han katungod pagbutos han mga ex-officio nga miyembro han konseho. Labi na ang ira pagpartisipar pagpili han mga opisyales han sangguni ang panglungsod.
Yes. I would like to inform this August body, yes, of a DILG opinion number 016-99, which somehow informs us that ex-officio members are not allowed to participate and vote in the creation or organization of a regular or standing committee. And may I read the DILG opinion,
Mr.
Standing Officer? So the query is, are the barangay and youth representatives as ex-officio members in the Sangguniang Bayan entitled to vote during sessions of the Sangguniang? Are they included in the determination of a quorum? And number two, can the same ex-officio members vote and or participate in the creation or organization of a regular or standing committee? So, in reply to this query, the answer of the DILG is as to the second query, which is applicable to the case of hand.
Yes.
In reply to your second query, please be further informed that generally, ex-officio members of the Sangguniang Bayan should not be allowed to participate and vote in the organization of the Sangguniang's various committees, although they are assured of their respective committee chairmanship as granted them under the law. This is because the organization of the various committees is generally based on the majority and minority parties in the Sangguniang, which in turn is based on political party affiliation. In that regard, it should be remembered that the SK chairman and the Punong Barangay were elected under a non-partisan election and therefore not being identified or affiliated with any political party, they cannot be properly considered in the determination of majority and minority parties in the Sangguniang. The DILG opinion number 85 dated May 29, 1998 and the DILG opinion number 112 dated September 7, 1998, Mr. Presiding Officer. With due respect,
yes,
with no offense to the members, the SK President and the ABC President.
As clearly stated, this is only the opinion of our LG. And it is not part of any law. In fact, it's not part of our internal rules. And we have just approved the adoption of our internal rules, which calls for the election. And as that's it, that nobody is accepted from participating in this activity. So we are pushing the election.
The 2007 internal rules of procedure does not specifically provide that the ex-officio members can participate in the petition.
Okay.
So, therefore, that is not specifically provided that they cannot participate in the election of the internal matters of the Sangguniang Bayan, so they being only an ex-officio by virtue of their office.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Don't worry, we've been pursuing the elections as we have been doing. And
yes,
as suggested by Honorable Domingo, we proceed with the election. If there are any questions, they can challenge the proper form.
Mr. Presiding Officer,
Honorable Esperas is recognized.
We are not objecting to the continuance of the election. What we are just manifesting is that the election go ahead, but the SK President and the ABC President are excluded from participation there in.
Is
citing that DILG legal opinion. If there is somebody else who can cite other provisions or other opinions contrary to what we have stated, then we would gladly listen.
For the previous Sanggunian, and I was not barred from participating with this kind of process. Why not? Even the last Sanggunian, Honorable Uy was a member, and he did not object with my participation. So much so with the SK Federation President. Why only now? He didn't agenda him? Then if you would want to become as one, as we all have, we have been elected, sworn and everything. So why should we be banned from participating with this exercise?
I believe this is just and fair for the legal president, the SK president, to appoint an advocate to participate, since this has been as straight related by the Pineda. This has been going on for as long as we can remember, not only here in Atlantan City, as well as many other cities and provinces. So I really, the information that I have, nobody has really implemented what was the Honorable Esquerra has mentioned about the asylum opinion. So from what I know, nobody has really followed that opinion so far, all the other local elections.
This is only day one. And I appeal to my colleagues, let's just proceed with the election of the chairman chair. So again, no, we may demand good legality out of actions today. They not always challenge the legality of our actions, no. But I appeal, Masana, let's just proceed first with the election of the committee chairmanship. Because we can discuss this back and forth, is it a game, as quadra, as inco. But I appeal, please, this is only day one, the 12th Sanggunian Panglungsod. So let's just proceed with the election of the committee chairmanship.
As mentioned, it is very clear that the one of the police titles to the Sanggunian, saying that the ABC and the SK were not allowed to vote in the Sanggunian elections, in previous elections, not as election. It's not true. Not only memory will serve us, but it is on record. As mentioned by Honorable Pineda, if there are hidden agenda, then you cannot avoid that there are further discussions and elections. But I suggest we proceed to vote, then let them question it in the proper forum. If they want to.
This is just the first day of this new Sanggunian, and I would just like to suggest that sana huwag tayo divisive. Let's not be divisive, and let's just work for what we really are supposed to do as members of the Sanggunian, to try to work as one for the good of the people and for the good of the local government, di ba? Kasi if we're just gonna think of our political whatever, you know, it's just a political move. I really don't know what all these suggestions. But for me, whatever is best for the committees, whatever is best for the Sanggunian, for the LGU in general, so that we can just move and do what we're supposed to do, which is really part of our job. That's why we were elected as councilors.
Basehan 2007 Sangguni ang Panglungsod Revised Internal Rules and Procedures in waray nakasurat bahin han kawaray partisipasyon han mga ex officio nga miyembro han konseho pagbutos para han mga posisyon ha sangguni ang panglungsod. Salit kahuman manuminar ni ra Konsehal Edwin Chuang ang Konsehal Jerry Uy para floor leader in pata sa naging resulta o sa is nga butos han pareho nga nakuha han duha nga konsehal. Gindesisyonan iningatay ni SP Presiding Officer Sambuyaw Kasin, tinaagihan iya pagbutos kan Konsehal Chua como floor leader.
My colleagues, since we are now in the election, the majority floor, I hope to nominate the Honorable Chua to be to be our majority floor leader in this 12th Sangguniang Pamunsan.
Thank you, Mr. Standing Officer, good afternoon, my colleagues. Thank you, Dominic, Honorable Jerry Puy, for the position of floor leader of Standing and Public Service.
Yes. Kakawi, please. How?
Six.
Those who are in favor, Honorable Jerry Puy, as the floor leader of the Talk Standing and Public Service, please raise your hand.
Six.
Six. So. So in that case, there is a tie for the position of floor leader in the Dolph Sangguniang and Pangasur. And may I ask our Sangguniang secretary, in the case of a tie, what is the provisions under the 207 internal rules of procedure?
Section 27 provides that in case of a tie, the presiding officer shall cast his vote, except that he is precluded from voting due to some private, pecuniary, or other personal considerations that may tend to affect his judgment to the prejudice of the service or the body.
Now we can quote the Bible verse in the book of Esther. Queen Esther was assigned to the position as the Queen of Persia. There was a quote here. You were put in that position for such a time as this. You gotta tie them up. It's six. And the role of the Lord leader. So important to feel under the fears of the Sangguniang and Pangasiun. I hope next 3 years will be good for issues that we choose. We will always reflect the good hearts of each member of the Sangguniang and Pangasiun. Secretary, can you please leave the provisions, the revised internal rules? What is the function of our program? Let's share with us.
Sumalakan BC Alcalde Yaucasin ang mabugat ng importansya han floor leader kumo liaison officer han konseho tikad tuan alcalde o executive branch han syudad han iya naging basehan pagpili kan Konsehal Chua.
And he has also served as the city vice mayor, presiding officer, for 6 years. And the present configuration, the present political situation, would dictate that if we have Honorable Chua as the floor leader, the lines between the office of the mayor and the office of the city and the city would be better. And we owe it to ourselves, the next 3 years, we would have a converting relationship. Okay, congratulations to both of you. You are both deserve the position, but only one can be the floor leader. So, and Honorable Edwin Chua is now the floor leader of the Dolph Sangguniang and Pangasiun.
Ang mga bag-o nga napili nga committee chairperson sa Sangguniang Panglungsod, amo ang masunod.
We'll be right back.
ira mga inaugural speeches ingindiguna ni Vice Alcalde Yaucasin ug sugad man ni First Lady Councilor Cristina Romualdez ang importansya han pagburublig. Magkaiba man ang partido politikal nga gintikangan, inangay na magkaurusan mga opisyales ang syudad, agud masiguro nga mas mapaupay pa ang serbisyo publiko nga maihahatag ha mga Taklobanon.
Let us work in unity and more concerned of the services that we can mahatag ha mga Taklobanon. So again, let us be a light, let us be a good example, and let us all work together in a good way. So may God bless us all, may God bless us, Sangguniang, the Vice Mayor, the Mayor, and all of us. Thank you and good afternoon.
Tapos naman yung kampanya, tapos naman yung eleksyon, kailangan na magkaurusan kita. We must set aside our personal interests and political differences. Divided, there is little we can do. But united, there is little we can do. If we must fight, we must fight against us, Father. But we must never fight against each other. Kapurian, ang panginabuhi, kakulangan ng oportunidad, kawarayan ng pagdaon, hindi ang natong tunay na kagulungan. Diri kita na ang full kontra din isang kagulungan. I will continue to work with my fellow elected officials, whether administration or opposition, majority or minority, to ensure that our government will be transparent, accountable, and responsible. The agenda of our people must always be above and over our political allegiance to any person or political party. As an independent vice mayor, I am here as the representative of no person and no political party. I will only answer my God and my conscience. Being the vice mayor is more than an honor. It is more than a promise. It is the charge of God. By the grace of God, I will give it up. Thank you very much. God bless you. God bless you.